Oh, look, everyone, we've got a bit of a dilemma, and that is, where the heck are we going with this build? What's the vision? What is the goal? And I can tell you, when we first started this, I had zero clue. But I can also say that in real life, because we have somehow been able to alter time and space, that I'm looking at the completed car, actually. Yeah. And so just for kicks, we've added the sound effect of a vacuum cleaner to add to the ambiance. What was I saying? So anyway, recently you'd have seen that we've done a fair bit to the car with regard to preparing the panels. We've repaired some damage. We have also cleaned up a few things, removed some trim and whatnot. That's all very exciting. But in real life, suspension has been done. Fully independent rear suspension. It's a work of art, people. Moreover, the car has undergone a shuck end test. That's the roadworthiness. And that was a bit of a disaster. So we couldn't start it. Damn, kind of embarrassing. But we sorted it all out. We did. And then we got it registered for the road, and that was on Friday. And then Saturday and Sunday, I've been driving around. And not gonna lie, the car is stopping people in their tracks, and I got a shout out to Masaedu. We had a chat. He had a sweet S14 Silvia, amazing. I'm gonna bring that to you maybe on the Wasabi Cars channel at some time in the future. Very, very cool car. I'm dealing with a little bit of nervous energy, which I'm attempting to walk off, so forgive me for that. But check out this amazing illustration by Coop AK, fantastic. And then we're gonna use that as a canvas to express some ideas for our project car. So it's a stunning car. It needs a livery, does it not? It looks a bit plain white. And why don't you let us know some race car liveries that are memorable for you. And now let me tell you all about the direction I want to go in, and that is in the direction of Peter Brock. Now, in Australian motoring history, he's probably the guy. He's the LeBron James of, let's say, basketball. If you know what I'm saying, he's the guy. And he's since passed away, to be honest. But growing up, I would legit sit on the sofa next to my dad watching the Australian Touring Car Championship, watching Bathurst and the endurance races and battles with General Motors v Ford. And the dude raced plenty of cars over a very long and storied, I've never used that word before, career. And also he raced under many liveries and many sponsors. But the one that's sticking in my mind is that of the 1978-1979 A9X Taranas. That is such a beautiful livery. And actually, that sort of did carry over to the early Holden Commodores. And then we're talking, my first car was a VK Calais. And have you typed your livery IDs in the comment section below? I really do look forward to going through there and doing some research on the cars that have made impressions in your life. So yeah, we're totally going for the Marlborough livery on this bean of a car. What do you think?
Oh. Oh, what am I doing? Oh, what am I doing? Oh my God, I'm gonna show you, people. Oh, what am I gonna, oh, yeah, oh, there it is. Bye-bye.